let's see, I have the paints, I have the book, I have brushes, I have water. I might have just a little bit of rum. I have a little girl. I have no idea what the little boy is doing. He's wandering around inside the house. His mother's in the house. And we've been abandoned by the dogs. One of the dogs is sick. Yeah. So the mother is not very, very happy. My beautiful young bride is not very happy with us right now for leaving her in the house with a sick dog. So, let's see. Take off your headphones. Hello and welcome to this week's episode of The Artistic Biker, live from Houston, America. That's right, Houston, America. Make America great again. No, no, no. I don't mean to sound political. I just love living in Houston. It's a lot of fun. So, we have been playing so far with watercolors and letting them flow and do whatever they want to do. And it started with... where'd the duck go? Did you take the duck back away?
No.
Where is it then?
I don't know.
Oh, goodness. It's gone. Forget it. It started with some fun that the little girl and I were doing when I showed her her dandelion card that I painted her. And then I gave her a demonstration on how water flowed. Anyway, so we did a free $2 tutorial. The organization on this show is just amazing. Amazing. I got to tell you, we're just so organized. Anyway, so don't laugh. It's not funny.
I'm sorry.
So, okay. So we did a free $2 tutorial on water flow, which is, you know, nothing but watching the water flow. I mean, pretty simple stuff. So, but I'm going to play with it on my page just a little bit. No idea what I'm going to... Like a chicken with his head cut. No idea. But let's get the intro to the YouTube video out of the way, and then we will we'll go on from there. You know what? We should do... Subliminal Baby. We haven't done Subliminal Baby in years.
Wait, what?
We should do Subliminal Baby. We haven't done Subliminal Baby in years.
What is that?
You don't remember Subliminal Baby?
No. Oh!
Yeah. Okay, hang on.
I think you can pick me up.
Oh, I can absolutely pick you up. You know I can pick you up.
I'm like 100-something pounds.
Hello, peoples! Welcome to this week's episode of The Artistic Biker. Last time on The Artistic Biker, it was a complimentary sunset where we had done a value study with the yellows and purples. So the complimentary value study, we'd gone from purple to yellow, and then we shaded it and we tinted it, and it gave us a whole palette of colors to play with, and so we painted a sunset with it. When you do a limited palette sunset, when you do a monochrome, or when you do a complimentary thing like this, you are allowed to use black and white because those are neutrals. Some people say you are allowed to use brown and gray, but I don't know, because the brown and grays you should be able to mix with your complementary colors. Anyway, that's what we did last week. This week, we have been playing with letting our watercolors flow into each other. The little girl and I did a private lesson, and then we did a free $2 tutorial based on it. And now we're going to journal a little bit about it. So with that, let's turn the page and get started. All right. I need something that flashes.
Me.
No, you're pretty flashy, but that's not what I mean.
She's wearing pink.
Come here. Come to me.
And I feel
sorry,
fine.
Just keep your boob that way. Look at her. Look at her in pink.
She's so
pretty in pink. She's wearing pink. She hates pink. She hates pink with a passion.
I love you.
The things I do for my students in my school.
So
I wear hot pink.
It's only hot because you're wearing it. She just got home. She's been hanging her students' artwork.
Well, that's tomorrow.
Oh, what have you been doing?
This was sorting the artwork, getting the labels ready, and making sure that they're allowed to be displayed in or out of the district. You have to check all 1,000 names to make sure that the 60 that you've selected And, you know, you throw out 40 of them because their parents said, no, please don't put my child's name, artwork, photograph, or anything in or out of the district. And you have to check.
Is that what happened? 40 of them said no?
Oh, yeah.
40 of them?
Yeah, a good
out of 60?
A good 30 out of the ones. Yeah, a good 30 at least. Because every time we pulled it, I was like, okay.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a 14-page document of kids that said no, and I have to go through, and if they only put their first name, then I have to figure out what their last name is and which class they're in so that I can make sure that I got the right kid, because there's a lot of Isabellas.
I bet there's a few Isabella Garcias.
Yes. Diego's.
Yeah.
Sebastian's.
Jonathan Smith.
No, there's like four Jonathans. I'm like, holy moly. So I had to go through.
John Smith.
No, there's no Smith. I don't have a single Smith kid.
How many chins do you have?
I just have one.
I have four. I need to lose weight.
Well, that's a whole lot of long numbers.
So, easy with your racist comments.
No, in the... you... If you've ever seen Hudson Hawk, they were counting how many wongs there were in the phone book.
That's a lot of wong numbers. Okay, let me draw this real quick. We'll take a break. We'll be right back.
No offense meant.
You know, we don't really go anywhere. Just something we say for the YouTube.
For our lunch and planning, which is why all my show stuff can get done. Because this meeting that should have only taken about 30 minutes took over an hour, which meant that we had to eat while we sat there. And it was good because it's with my team. And we've never met like that before. But ask the little boy if he wants some. But it was kind of rotten.
He's not allowed to have beer or rum.
I know. It was just... It meant that I didn't get the work hung.
So I
didn't get it mounted, which means that I have all day yesterday, and I have to do it either in between classes or when they're with the artists. Or
what do you mean you had all day yesterday?
I had all day. I have to do it tomorrow.
You said yesterday. Did you mean yesterday?
I don't know what I meant.
Is that your mind going?
That was my mind. I'm already on tomorrow.
Because you're about to go through the change or something.
No.
I think I'm going through the change. Now that I'm older.
I think I'm going to, like, grow 2 inches and lose, like, 75 pounds. That's what kind of change I want to go through.
And so I'd like to grow 2 inches, too.
Yay!
Oh, you took that to a dark place. You're a bad person.
Am I?
That's what I meant, but, it's not important. I'm not really prepared. I'm spreading this, this golden ground around on this page. This stuff... if you haven't been here before, this stuff is cool. It turns whatever surface it is on into watercolor paper. So you can take a chrome hubcap, and you can spread golden absorbent ground on a hubcap, and it will make the hubcap into watercolor paper. But it takes a couple of layers. So let me dry this one.
Not yet.
Okay.
It's not dried.
Okay. We'll show it off for what's on your easel. By the way, if you haven't sent anything in for what's on your easel, there's still time.
Do so now.
Send your easels in to blade@artisticbiker.com with the subject line easel, and we will use your works to inspire other people to do works, because that is what we are here for. I'm not here to show off my amazing talent, because God knows I have no amazing talent. I just have fun doing it. I am here to inspire you to do something. And if you even pick up a brush, I am fulfilled. So I just spattered gesso all over my tablet. I'm going to have to put a piece of plexiglass up right there. I can tell you right now. I'm going to have to put a piece of plexiglass up right there. But I'm not here to show off any kind of amazing talent. That's not what this is about. This is about This is honestly, this whole thing is about glorifying you guys. It's about getting you guys up, glorifying. I've been singing gospel, and now I'm talking about glorifying people. It's the whole point of this is to encourage and inspire you guys to get up and paint, get up in art. I don't care if it's paint. I don't care if you're making love to something. I don't care poetry. I don't care. Just get up in art, and then send it to me. Especially if you're arting during my show, send it to me, and I'll share it with everybody, and we'll use your works to inspire other people. Hair right there. We'll use your works to inspire other people because that is what this is all about. Anyway, that's my what's on your easel spiel. So, okay, two coats. Two coats is plenty. That's right, it's about the process, not the product. It's about the process, not the product. One more drying time. Won't lay down his heavy load. Why don't you swing down, chair, stop and let me ride? Okay, so we've got one coat of gesso. Really, you should have two coats of gesso. We have one coat of gesso, and we have two coats of ground. Really, you can put up to four coats of the ground to really get the good effect. And truly, you should let the ground cure for 8 hours or so. If you're going to do anything, if you really wanted to paint anything special on a hubcap, let the stuff dry overnight. Just put the stuff on there, scuff it up a little bit, put the stuff on there, go to bed, get up the next morning and paint. It works better. The longer it has to cure, the better it works. But it's going to be fine for our purposes because it's an art journal, and we're here for process, not product. Most of the time, I'm just trying something that I want to see how it's going to work out anyway. So, hey, K-Bird. So, let's see. I still think that's a little wet right there, but I don't know. I'm kind of afraid to put any water on top of it because I'm afraid that it will lift it. But let's go ahead and see if we can't get a background going. So I'm going to spritz the page. We're going to lubricate the page, and then I'm going to come in with my. You know what? I don't want to use that brush. I want to use this brush. I want to use a bigger brush. Come in with a brush here. And I'm not even going to be the slightest bit careful. I'm going to get some blue. I'm not even going to be the slightest bit careful. I want this stuff to spread around. Make sure I stay in the blue. It's not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough water. There we go. I'm going to have to go get some more water. I can already tell you my spritzer is empty. There we go. There we go. It's moving now. That's what I wanted to see. I wanted to see it flowing. And then, I don't know, let's do a landscape. I don't normally do landscapes. Normally landscapes bore me. But let's just have some fun. And let's see if we can get some flow out of this. I don't know if we're going to be able to. We got a little bit. See the purple streak there? We got a little bit going on so far. I'm not even being careful, guys. If you can't tell, I'm not even being careful. I want to make sure that's nice and wet right there. Because the whole purpose of this tonight is to see if we can't get some. If we can't get some flow between the colors, I want to see the colors disperse. And they're not doing it. I had no problem with it. Any other time, I have no problem with my colors trying to blend into each other. But I'm trying to do a show about the colors blending into each other, and damned if they won't just not move. So, all right. It's all right. We can live with it. We can live with it. Give me this brush. Give me the fat brush. That's what we want. Let's get the fat brush in here. Now let's get some. This will be fine for a background. We'll be all right. I don't know what we're going to do for a foreground. This will be fine for a background. All right. I'm going to let... Look, we've got some nice things happening over here. I'm going to let this set up for a little bit. We're going to call this... We're going to call this the background. And hang on a second. Let me see if I can get the kids out here before we do what's on your easel. And then we'll get the boy to sing what's on your easel. Hang on. We haven't done Subliminal Baby in a long time. Children! Come here.
Hello.
Used to be, we would do Subliminal Baby.
Oh, my hair is wet.
And the videos, your hair is braided. The videos, everybody would watch these videos and they'd be like, what is this crap? Why are we watching this crap? This is stupid. This video is stupid. Why are we watching this stupid video? Oh, look, a baby. There's a baby.
Do it first.
So it'd be like, why are we watching this stupid video? This is terrible. This is terrible artwork. Oh, look, there's a baby. Look at the baby. Oh, what a pretty baby. Honey, come here and look at this cute baby.
Ow. Don't do me.
I have to.
I'm too long.
I have to.
It
started with you.
Yeah, Norma did because you were infant.
So it'd be like, hey, honey, come look at this cute baby. Oh, look at baby. That. Look at the cameras above you.
Hello, baby.
Baby.
Look, he's got his first grade. No teeth. don't run off. We're going to do what's on your easel.
Okay.
They've gotten big. So let's do.
It hurts.
You see, I put my finger in there to test if that was still wet, and I pulled it right up. None of it is cure, and that's kind of the problem of not letting it cure before you move on to the next phase. But you know what I was saying while the hair drying was going on is I don't know when you dry it fast like that. When you dry it fast like that, can you see the cracks? Can you see the cracks in the paint? I don't know if you can. If I can turn it, if you can see the cracks in the gesso, where the paint has seeped into the cracks because it dried so fast that it caused cracks in it. And to me, it's the imperfections that make it special. It's just like all the people in your life, you know. The imperfections are what separate them from everybody else. You can be just like everybody else. Anybody can be like everybody else, but only you can be you, and only they can be them. So this is still just sopping wet right through here. So I'm going to go back, and I have to dry it. I can't move on to the next phase. But I wanted to make sure the hair drying wasn't on when I said that. Alcohol abuse. I think that's going to work for us. So, let's do this. Let's take our fat brush. And the biggest problem with this is the paper's not flat. So it's really hard. Water has cohesive tension. Water likes to hold on to itself. Water is magnetic to itself. And so it's why when you have a puddle of water on the edge of the table, you can put your finger in the puddle of water and drag it to the edge of the table, and the water spills off the edge of the table and it pulls the whole puddle off the edge of the table. It's why the water will pool right up to the edge of the table. When you spill your drink, the water will pool right up to the edge of the table. But then once it starts to fall off the table, it just sucks everything down. Water is magnetic to itself. We call that cohesive tension. When it does pool, you'll notice that it sometimes has a little profile to it. You can see it from the edge. There's a little edge, and then there's a surface, and then it has another edge on the other side. And that's because of the cohesive tension. And when you have a perfectly flat surface and perfectly flat paper, and your paper is taped down and not buckled and the whole works, that cohesive tension can work in your favor for anything you want to do. But in our situation, because I'm working in this book with all of these ripples and waves going across here, these imperfections, these little divots here, I don't know if you can tell the paper is warped right there, that when I go and put water here, it's liable to run to the middle of the page. And so that causes a problem, because once it starts running to the end of the page, it will run, all of it will run to the center of the page. So I'm going to start down here in the lower corner. No, I'm not. I'm going to start right here. That's where I want to start, right there. Get some green on there. Make sure I have lots of green on there. I don't care if it drips. I'm just going to come around like that and see how much of that I can get to just flow into place. Right? We don't care if it runs. We'll come back and define any shapes we want to define with the ink brush, because I love my brush pen. We'll come back and define anything we want after the fact. We don't need anything to make it stay in a specific place right now. Right now, all we want to happen right now is we want the water to flow. We want the paint to flow. Right now. That's what we're after. So we're just going to make sure we have plenty of lubricant for the paint. And we're going to get it to, we're just going to do our very best to make it just flow like that. I love science too, Pamela French. My degree is in biology. I am not a degreed artist. I am by education a scientist. And that really comes in handy with some of this stuff, because with some of this stuff, everybody says, well, you can't do that. Well, you know, prove it, because, you know, I did. What do you mean I can't? Can't's a pretty strong term there. Can't, won't, and shouldn't are three totally different words.
Art.
Did you guys hear that? I have an alarm on my phone. At 8 o'clock, I have an alarm on my phone that goes off and it says art. Because 8 o'clock is bedtime for the kids. And so that's when I'm free to come out to the garage and just art to my little heart's content. I'm not in any rush tonight, guys. I'm going to enjoy myself. If you can manage to make it to the end, that's great. If we run out of time, I'm sorry. But I have no intentions of turning the camera off anytime soon. So this is something I've wanted to play with for a while. I'm gonna get some purple because I think that's cool. I might be the only one who thinks that's cool, but I like it, and it's my book, and you know what that means. I do what I like. Look at that. You know what I want to do on top of that? I want to come through and I want to put some indigo Where's my indigo? I think that's my indigo. Let me see right there. Yeah, I'm gonna get a little indigo. Just a little bit of indigo. I'm gonna come down around this side. I'm gonna come down through here. Like that. I'm gonna come down around this side. I'm gonna come down around through that like that. I'm gonna come around here. I'm gonna come down through here. I'm just gonna let it do whatever it does. If it works, it works. Ooh. If it doesn't, we learned something, right? That's right. Missy Alley is saying you are the boss of your own journal. That's exactly right. It's my book. And that's the thing you have to remember. If you are doing this, if you are playing along in your own art journal, the thing you have to remember is, you know, show it to somebody, don't show it to somebody. Who cares? It's your book. Do what you want. If you want to use your book as a learning tool, use your book as a learning tool. If you want to use your book as a place to play, use it as a place to play. It's your book. Do what you love. Do what you love. And that's the thing. So many people, nobody wants to see that. Who cares if nobody wants to see it? Do you want to see it? Is it interesting to you? And you may never be interested in it again. You may never be interested in it again. Are you interested in it today? Is it something today? Is it something that you would like to play with? And if it's something you would like to play with today, then it's your book. By all means. You know what? I'm going to do that in some various places here, but I want to do one color at a time. So, let me do that in other places first. But it's your book. You do whatever makes you happy in your book. There's absolutely no reason why you have to try and satisfy somebody else's expectations of what art is. And that's the biggest problem I have with... That is the biggest problem I have. Oh, you should learn to draw. You know what? If you don't want to learn to draw, don't learn to draw. Maybe you just want to play with colors. Maybe it's been a stressful day and you just want to play with colors. Nobody should be allowed to criticize you for playing with colors in your book. And nobody can criticize you for playing with colors in your book. It's your book. You can do what you want with it. And you hang it on a wall. Don't hang it on the wall. Tear it out and give it to somebody. Don't tear it out and give it to somebody. You know? It's yours. You can do whatever you like with it. You can absolutely do anything you like with it. You don't have to do anything at all special. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to satisfy anybody's needs but yours. The whole point of this is to open a door for your creativity, is to let you do something and express your creativity. I firmly believe that human beings will never be happy if they don't find the door for their creativity, if they don't find an outlet for their creativity. I was writing a book at one time, and I probably should get back to it because, you know, I don't know. You know, you feel like you should do something, and then you don't do it, and then you feel like you're missing out because you didn't do it. Well, I was writing a book at one time called The Creator Spark. And in The Creator Spark, the premise of the book was everybody has a creative spark in them. I don't care if you're a creationist. I don't care if you're an evolutionist. I don't care if you're Hindi. I don't care if you're Muslim, Christian. It doesn't matter to me. Whatever your belief system, there's a way to work this into your belief system. And let me explain. If, for instance, if you are a Christian creationist, because that's the one I'm most familiar with, if you are a Christian creationist and you believe that you are made in the image of God, well, if God is a creator, then you have to be a creator also. It has to be in your nature. If God is a creator, then you have to be a creator also, because you were made in His image, right? So if you were made in His image, then you have to be a creator too. Obviously not on His scale.
Hi, Mom. How was your day?
But let's say you're an evolutionist. Let's say you don't believe in any of that jazz. That's okay too. I'm an evolutionist. Let's say it. I'm an evolutionist and I don't believe in any of that jazz. Okay, so you're an evolutionist. Your ancestry had to be creative in order to survive the wilderness. You had to figure out how, with no natural weapons of your own. Lions and tigers have teeth and claws. You don't have teeth and claws. You don't have anything like that. Jaguars, all of them, teeth and claws. All of the rest of the predators have teeth and claws. Even baboons have teeth and claws. We don't have teeth and claws. How are we supposed to survive? Creativity. We picked up sticks. I'm going to say that again. I'm going to say it slowly. I want you to understand. We picked up sticks. What does that mean, we picked up sticks? We didn't have the weapons necessary to compete with the predators in our environment. So we picked up sticks. That is practically creativity by definition. We imagined. No other animal picks up sticks to fend off their enemies. We imagined that we could use the sticks as a weapon, and we did. To fend off our enemies. To fend off the tigers, the lions, the tigers. Our ancestors used their imagination, used their creativity to survive. We imagined a means to store food for the winter. We imagined a means to share food with our neighbors. We imagined a means to trade food and supplies with our neighboring tribes. No other animal has done that. Regardless of anything else we've done, no other animal has imagined a means of trade. Absolutely no other animal has imagined a means of trade. So, whether you are a creationist, or whether you are an evolutionist, or whatever your particular belief system is, the truth of the matter is, creativity is part of your being. And you will not be happy if you're not creating. That doesn't mean paint. I like to paint. That not everybody likes to paint. I see people all the time. I can't draw a stick figure. Okay, you know why you can't draw a stick figure? Because you don't want to. You know what I am not a concert pianist. You know why I'm not a concert pianist? Because I do not want to spend 6 hours a day learning to play piano. I want to play piano. I just don't want to spend 6 hours a day doing it. I don't want to spend 6 hours a day learning. I want to play. I want to play guitar. I don't want to spend 6 hours a day practicing and learning to play guitar. I do want to be able to draw. I do want to be able to draw. And so I spend 2 to 3 hours a day drawing and painting. What does that say? So again, you are creative. You have the creative gene in your body. You cannot not have the creative gene in your body. I think that these red flowers, I think they need a spot of blue or something right in the middle. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to add a pool of water. I don't know how well it's going to work out. Let's see how well it works out. I'm going to get a little blue. I just want to put like that. Honestly, could that have worked out any better? Considering what we're going for, could that have worked out any better? Ooh, look at it go. This is going to take forever to dry. See that big green pool right there? This is going to take forever to dry with a hairdryer. We probably are not going to be able to move this tonight. So, I am going to... Let's see, is there a color I haven't utilized? I mean, I could move the indigo around a little better. I mean, I could come through here like this, and I could get some indigo, and I could move the indigo around like that. But see, then that's the risk you have right there. And I guess I'm okay with that. I mean, it's not my intent, but it's part of my love of watercolors in that they are, it's kind of like they are, I don't know how you say it. It's not, I don't believe that they have an intelligence, but they do what they do. You know, watercolors just do what they do. And so, it's not my intent to obscure that background that we did before, but I'm hoping that as the colors dry, they kind of blend into what was there before. Oops. Forgot to flood it first. I don't know. The other book, and I don't know if it's actually a separate book, but the other book that I was talking about writing was Stacking Your Dominoes. You know, you can't control that tomorrow the world's going to implode. But that shouldn't stop you from stacking your dominoes or planting your seeds or whatever your impulse in life is. And I don't know if I'm... It's hard to flesh out a book while you're painting at the same time. But the creative spark is one that I've been meaning to write for years. Maybe I'll work on that. Maybe that's my goal for this year, is to get the creative spark on paper. You know. Maybe that's a good, that's probably a good goal, is to get the creative spark on paper. How do you avoid tearing the page with all that water? Miss Allie, we started with gesso, and the whole point of gesso is to waterproof the page. I use acrylic gesso. Actually, what I use instead of acrylic gesso is I use Kills, which I actually called the Kills Company. It is the exact same binder as acrylic gesso. And the difference is that acrylic gesso is like $8 an ounce, and Kills is $16 a gallon. So I actually use Kills. And once you use the gesso or the Kills on your page, you have essentially, you've watercolored the page. I'm sorry, you've waterproofed the paper. And I can't really show you because this is going to take forever to dry. The amount of the sheer volume of water on here has made this where it's going to take forever to dry. Get this top corner up here. And we didn't get this area right here. But I think that we need some. Ooh, I like that. What do you think of that? That's awesome. I'm going to come back through the middle there with a little bit of indigo just to indicate some tonal edging. A tonal edge is when you get to the edge of an object. You don't want to draw a line. You don't want to draw a contour line. You want the edge to just kind of shade into existence. And so sometimes you just want to put a tonal edge on stuff. And so sometimes you actually want to put a contour around it. I don't even want to write on that. I'm not sure what I want to do with that. I don't even think I want to write on it. And I don't have to. To write on anything if I don't want to. Now, granted, what I usually say is that if it's an art journal, there should be journaling. But sometimes a picture is worth 1,000 words. Right? Sometimes that's all you need. Well, I like this. I'm just going to leave it like it is. The only thing I'm going to add to it is I'm going to add this. I have this white acrylic paint here. I don't think I'm going to add any journaling. How are we doing on time? Is it 8:30? 8:20? I'm going to make sure that I have all of the paint out of my brush over here. Yeah, I gesso, Miss Allie, I gesso the paper because the book is made out of... because the book is made out of used paper grocery sacks, I gesso the page. But once I gesso the page, then it's not absorbent at all. And that's why we used the absorbent ground to give it the watercolor texture. So... that is why we're where we're at right now, to tell you the truth. So I'm just going to add some highlights here. I can't blend them in because there's a lot of water still on this page. So I really just kind of have to let this stuff settle. And I have to let it flow. I have to let it do what it does. But I can put this little bit of acrylic on top of this watercolor. And I can just let it do what it does. I don't even want to journal on it. Well, I could, I don't know what I'd write. But I really like that. I mean, that's just fun. So yeah, Miss Allie, it's not watercolor paper. It's I can't really show you because it'll move the water, but it's the journal is made out of used grocery sacks, brown paper bags, and so I made the journal, and we'll make a new one. Probably make a new one in September. We usually make a new one in September. I'll make a new one in September, and the journal. But the journal is made out of used grocery sacks. I have to drink more because the only place I found around here that has used grocery sacks is the liquor store. So I'll have to drink more to make sure that I have enough used grocery sacks to make another book. But and trust me, it's a sacrifice I'm willing to make. Anyway, so the journal is made out of used grocery sacks. We will make a new one in September, but anything I want to do, I have to gesso. I have to start with gesso. I have to waterproof the paper. It's not like it's waterproof watercolor paper. Now I have, if I wanted to do a watercolor commission, for instance, I would use. Ow! I have Arches. Somewhere I have Arches 300-pound cold press, and I have Arches 300-pound hot press. And then the wife was using this the other night when we were all in here arguing together. This is a watercolor block. And this watercolor block, the beauty, I don't know if you can see, the watercolor block is sealed all the way around so that the paper is a block. The paper acts as it might as well be 900-pound paper. It's thick and it's glued down on the edges, and it's stressed and it's pressed and then it's sealed on the edges. And so when you watercolor on it, it doesn't buckle or bow or do anything. So if I wanted to do a commission, and I've done commissions before watercolor, if I want to do a watercolor commission, I would do it on something like this. I wouldn't do it on newsprint or grocery sacks, unless that was something that unless that's something that the customer was interested in doing. Customer's not the right word. What's the word I'm looking for? Patron. If it's something that the patron wanted done, then we could talk about it. We could work that into the pricing and the scheme. But if I were doing something that I want to preserve forever, I would do it on the good quality stuff. This stuff is stuff I do to learn, to practice, to have fun, to play with, and I encourage everybody. It doesn't matter. We're not trying to create archival stuff here. We're trying to create stuff for fun. And look at the fun we had. Look at the fun we had. It was great stuff. But we have to gesso the paper to stop even the acrylics from soaking into the paper. And then once we gesso the paper, we can do whatever we want to it. We can acrylic on top of it. We can oil paint on top of it if we wanted to. But you know, it takes forever for oil paint to dry. We can do what we did tonight, where we used the golden absorbent ground on top of the gesso to give it more of a watercolor paper effect. And I really like the flow of this. I may come back. As a matter of fact, let's play with it just a little bit and see what happens. Let me get my brush pen, because I love my brush pen. I don't know if I've ever told you before, but I don't know if I've ever told you before, but I love my brush pen. So I'm just going to come through with my brush pen, and I'm just going to hit some details that I wanted to. That I wanted to be in there. I love my brush pen. Love it. The only thing with a brush pen, this one's full of ink, and so the only thing is that if you overuse it in this situation, you will overpower everything you've done, and you don't want to overpower what you've done. You want to make sure that the watercolor is the emphasis, but you also want to make sure that you've emphasize the areas that you want. So you've got your highlights where you want them. That was the white acrylic, and then you've got your darkest points where you want them. That's the indigo and the watercolor brush. Anyway, I'm done. I'm not going to jack with this anymore. This turned out better than I ever thought it would. To tell you the truth. But I want to make sure you guys understand that I do absolutely love my brush pen. Anyway, so guys, thank you so much for joining me. This was the idea tonight was to play with the flow of water. We did a free $2 tutorial for Tuesday. We'll be online Tuesday, next Tuesday, about letting the water flow, letting the watercolors flow. We gessoed the page, we put absorbent ground on the page, and then we just spread the watercolors around. A lot of fun. And then we did, what all did we do? We had the babies in here for Subliminal Baby, which we haven't done in forever because, God, they're not babies anymore. I got a grandbaby now. I need my grandbaby up here so I can have, or down here rather, so that I can have Subliminal Baby with a grandbaby. But, you know, we timed that. We actually did that on purpose. I'm going to tell you one more story because that's what I'm here for. My oldest son is 26 and my youngest son is 6. My oldest daughter is 24 and my youngest daughter is about to turn, is 11. My youngest son's actually going to turn 7 next week, but my youngest daughter won't turn 12 until July. So what happened? Well, my oldest daughter came come to us, and don't, this is the point in the show when you need to get your young children out of the room. So my oldest daughter comes to me when she's 11, and she says, "Daddy, I don't believe in Santa Claus anymore." She turned, her birthday is December 2nd, and she comes to me, she just turned 11, and she says, "Daddy, I don't believe in Santa Claus anymore." Well, okay, the magic's dead. So we're kind of upset about that, but you know, it was time. She's 11, right? It's about the time. It's what, kind of past time, really. But okay, so that happens. And then the following year, just before she turns 12, it's October, just before she turns 12, she says, "Daddy, I'm too old to go trick-or-treating." Well, you know how I am about the Halloween-y season. Screw that. My wife and I are looking at each other, and this that one really kind of threw us for a loop. And so the wife and I are looking at each other, and we say, "You know what? We are too young to have a household without Santa Claus and trick-or-treaters." And so we started over. We were that close to being free. But now, they're 26 and 24, and these two are 12 and 11. Or 12 and 7, rather. So let's think about that. My granddaughter is just turned 3 in December. My granddaughter just turned 3. By the time these two stop spilling milk on my couch, my grandkids, I have a grandkid from my daughter. I'll probably have a grandbaby from my son, from my oldest son. They will spill milk on my couch, and they will have Santa Claus and trick-or-treating. And then by the time they stop Santa Clausing and trick-or-treating, these two kids will be in the age where they will be having babies of their own, and their kids will be Santa Clausing and trick-or-treating. And by the time that happens, the previous grandbabies will be old enough to be having kids of their own. So great-grandbabies will be Santa Claus. So I'm never going to have a household without Santa Claus or trick-or-treaters again, and I am never going to have a couch without milk stains on it. So that was the point. Kberg says, "I feel your pain." She has a 31-year-old and a 16-year-old. But did you do it on purpose, Kberg? There are no two more purposefully created kids in the world than the two that are in this house right now, because we had the girl, and because her sister was 13 years older by the time she was actually born, we didn't want her, she would grow up as an only child, so we didn't want her to grow up as an only child, but it took us 4 years to have another child, and so she essentially did grow up as an only child, so is he growing up as an only child. There are no kids in the world that were more wanted and planned for than these two. So the other two kids are wanted and loved, but wanted and planned for is the defining. He was our nice surprise. We always wanted more. So there you surprise. Oh goodness, the egg fairy showed up, and well, she had something in mind for us that we hadn't actually. But no, these two kids, no kids in the world were more planned and wanted than these two kids. So we will never have a couch without milk stains on it. I have no idea how that even came up. How in the hell did we get off on that? I don't know. Point of story, do what you love. Guys, thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. You know, this is my favorite night when I get to art with my besties. I look forward to it every week. Remember, we've moved to Mondays, and I'm sorry if I've stepped on somebody else's toes, but it is recorded. You can watch it hair drying and all on the Ustream, and then, of course, we added all the hair drying out for the YouTube, and lots of videos on the YouTube, 600 something videos on the YouTube. Go to look for The Artistic Biker, YouTube, Google, whatever. I'm all over the internet. Be sure and tune in next week, same Artistic Biker time, same Artistic Biker channel, and then we dance, then we dance until somebody says that they see me dancing, because that way I know that the lag is made up for and we don't have to worry about anybody missing out on the end of what was said. But somebody has to be nice enough to say that I'm dancing and not just let me go. Because if anybody just says, hey, let's see how long we can make him. I used to have people that would just come in and say, shh, don't tell him he's dancing. We'll just let him dance as long as he wants to dance. Okay, Pamela French sees me dancing. Mwah. Peace out, everybody. We'll see you next week.